explaining the Ranke parameter and nephrolytic effect. So before that, a small topic is there, the calculation of delta O and B. So from if B is given, the Ranke parameter B is given, we can find the delta O, or either if delta O is given, then B can be calculated. So let's move on to that small topic. So calculation of delta O and B, the formula is 15B is equal to mu 3 plus mu 2 minus 3 mu 1. So 15B is equal to mu 3 plus mu 2 minus 3 mu 1. So what is mu 3, mu 2 and mu 1? So in orbital diagram, let's take this 3F and 3P for D2. So 3F will be splitting 3 into 3 terms, that is T1G, T2G and A2G. And 3P is splitting into one term, that is 3T1GP. So this is F and this is P. So the transition, which are the transition? Three transitions are possible. T1G to T2G, T1G to T2G, then T1G to A2G, then T1G to T1GP. So three transitions are possible. So first transition is the lowest transition, that is mu 1. Mu 1, usually mu 1 is given in centimeter, so we can take it as wave number. So mu 1 and this is mu 2 and the last transition is mu 3. So this is mu 1, mu 2 and mu 3. So mu 1, here mu 1 is the lowest transition, T1G to T2G. So 15B, B is the Ranke parameter. What is Ranke parameter? The inter-electronic repulsion measuring parameter. So 15B is equal to mu 3 plus mu 2 minus 3 mu 1. So we can solve problems so you will understand better. And these are the conditions for finding the delta O or delta T. So first point is, for D1, D4, D6, D9 octahedral tetrahedral complexes, one electron transition is possible. So if you refer the orbital diagram, you can see only one transition is possible in D1, D4, D6, D9. Either T2G to EG or EG to T2G. So in these transition, what will be the delta value? The delta value or the delta O or delta T will be the energy of the one electron transition. So in either word we can write that if mu 1 is the given wave number for that only one electron transition, then delta O will be mu 1. So if the question is asking for D1 or D4, D6, D9 complexes giving mu 1, then delta O will be that mu 1. For D2, D3, D7, D8, 3 electron transitions are possible. So this is for D2. Similarly, D7, D8 and D3 have 3 electron transition. So in that case, what happens? Mu 1, mu 3, mu 2 are given. So in D3 and D8, in D3 and D8, the delta will be the energy of the lowest transition. So this is D2. If D3 and D8 is given, the delta will be mu 1. The lowest energy transition will be the delta. And in D2 and D7, like in this case, what will be the delta? The delta is the difference in energy of first and third transition. So first and third transitions energy difference will be the delta of D2 and D7. These are not usually asked in exams, because for D2 and D7 we need the Tanabe-Sugano diagram. So D2 and for D2 and D7 we need the TS diagram, Tanabe-Sugano diagram, for finding the delta O by B value. So this is not important, but this is very important. For D3 and D8, delta is energy of lowest transition or fundamental transition. And here what? D1, D4, D6, D9 also one electron transition is given. So the energy value will be equal to that transition, one energy of the that one electron transition. So let's solve some problems. So moving on to first problem, nickel H2O6 2+, nickel H2O6 2+ is given and there are three transitions, wave numbers are given. nu1, nu2, nu3. So first you have to find out the deconfiguration of this complex. So nickel H2O6 2 plus is given. So nickel is in 2 plus. So the configuration is D8. Nickel atomic number is 28. So 2 electrons are lost. So D8. So for D8, what will be the delta O? For D3 and D8, 3 electronic transitions are possible. So the lowest energy will be the delta O. So here we have to find the delta O and B also. So delta O will be lowest energy transition, that is lowest energy transition is nu1, 8500. Nu1 is 8500, nu2 15400 and nu3 26000. So among this, the lowest energy is what? Nu1, 8500 per centimeter. So delta O will be 8500 centimeter inverse. Now we have to find the B value. So the equation is 15B is equal to nu 3 plus nu 2 minus 3 nu 1. So we can substitute the values of nu 3, nu 2 and nu 1. So 15B is equal to nu 3 26,000 plus nu 2 15,400 minus 3 into 8,500. So 26,000 plus 15,400 minus, you can calculate 3 into 8,500 is 15,900. So 15B is equal to 15,900. 15B is 15B is equal to 15,900. So B is equal to what? B is equal to 15,900 divided by 15. So this can be cancelled. 1, 15, 9, 0, 90, 6, 90, then 0. 1, 0, 6, 0. Centimeter inverse is the B value. So delta O is equal to 8500 and B is equal to 1060 centimeter inverse. So how to calculate the delta O and B? If D3 and D8 are the configuration, the lowest energy transition is the delta value. And B can be calculated by 15B is equal to nu 3 plus nu 2 minus 3 nu 1. So coming to next problem, Cr F6 3 minus. So Cr F6 3 minus. So the Cr is in 3 plus. So chromium is 24, then D3. D3 is the configuration. So for D3 and D8, 3 electronic transitions are possible. So we will take the lowest electronic transition. So lowest electronic transition is, the nu 1 is 14,900. Then 22,400, then 34,800. So the lowest transition is what? Delta O is equal to 14,900 per centimeter. So here delta O is asked. If B is asked, then you can use 15B is equal to nu 3 plus nu 2 minus 3 nu 1 formula. So it's very simple. D2 and D7 are not usually asked in exams because it needs Tyrannus-Ivano diagram. So for D1, D4, D9, D6, D3, D8. For this, D1, D4, D9 and D6, only one electron transition is possible. So that energy will be the delta O. For D3 and D8, 3 electron transitions are possible and the lowest energy will be the delta O. So now we can move on to nepholocytic effect. So what is nepholocytic effect? The delocalization of metal electrons in molecular orbitals which influence the metal and ligand. Due to this delocalization of electrons in metal atom, the inter-electronic repulsion, is called the Rapkin parameter B. So that B is reduced. So when N effect, so I will pronounce it as N effect. So N effect will causes the B parameter to reduce. So the average inter electron repulsion is reduced to B dash. So B is the inter electron repulsion for a free ion. When a complex is formed, it is reduced to B dash. So always the Rucker parameter for complexes will be less than the free metal ion. So that is written here, B value for complexes is smaller than corresponding free metal ion. So for example, chromium 3 have 900 per centimeter, and for complexes it is less than 900. For CrF6, 700 something. So I will explain that later. So for nephrolysis, if it is delocalization of metal electrons over molecular orbitals that encompass both metal and ligand, will cause a decrease in inter-electronic repulsion. So B is reduced to B dash. So the nephrolysis effect and covalent character is interrelated. So if nephrolysis effect is greater, then beta value will be lower. See, B dash by D is beta. So if nephrolysis effect is greater, means what? The nephrolysis effect is greater, delocalization is greater, so beta dash will be lower. The reduction of inter-electron repulsion is lowering in a great amount. So B dash will be low value. If B dash is low value and B is constant, for any free metal ion, it will be a constant value. So whether it is in free state, so B value will be constant. So B dash is different. If B dash is low, if N effect is greater, then B dash will be low. If B dash is low, what happens? Beta value will be low. So if beta value is low, that means N effect is greater, beta value is low, then covalent character is greater. So for low beta value, covalency is greater. Covalent character will be greater. That is shown here, B dash by B is equal to beta, which is always less than 1. So the value will be 0.6 to 0.94 beta. So if B dash and B are equal, then beta will be 1. If beta is equal to 1, then it will be 100% ionic character. So lower the beta value, greater the covalent character. The covalency is always related to delocalization of electrons. So greater the delocalization of electrons, greater the covalency. Greater the delocalization of electrons means what? Greater the nephrolysis effect. Greater the nephrolysis means beta value will be less. So lower the beta value, greater the covalent character. So that's very important. Beta value low, covalency greater. So these are the beta value for, B value for the metal ion, free metal ion and complexes. So Cr3 is the free metal ion, chromium 3 plus, 915 per centimeter. I already said that B value for complexes will be less than free metal ion. So these are the complexes, iodine, bromine, chlorine, fluorine. So for iodine 615, for bromine 700, and for chlorine 720, and for fluorine 800. So which have greater? Fluorine. So fluorine have greater B value. B value is greater for fluorine. So here the B dash value is greater. So beta value will be greater. If beta value is greater, what happens? The covalency decreases. So which among the complex will have greater covalency? The complex which have beta value low. So beta value low means B value low. So B value is 615 here. So iodine will have lower B value, greater covalency. So iodine can have greater covalent character compared to bromine, chlorine, fluorine. So fluorine will be least covalent character, showing least covalent character. So beta decreases, covalency increases. And another point point related to beta values, softness. Softness and hardness. So softer the ligand, beta value decreases. So lower beta value means softer the ligand. So here, which is the lower beta value? Iodine. So iodine is softer ligand. So beta decreases, increase in delocalization. That I already explained. Increase in delocalization means increase in covalency. So this is the order. This is the order. F minus fluorine, then high water, then urea. That means nitrogen donor. Nitrogen donor, then oxygen donor, then carbon donor, then halogen. Halogens. So first comes fluorine. Why? Because fluorine have lower beta, greater beta value. Fluorine have greater beta value. Greater beta value for fluorine. So greater the beta value means lower covalency, lower covalent. So which among the following have lower covalent character? Fluorine. So this is the order of beta value. This is the order of beta value. Fluorine have high beta value, so lower covalent character. And iodine will be having high covalent character. Iodine will have high covalent character. You should remember either one point, either covalency or either beta value. So it's easy to remember beta value. Lower beta value, greater covalency. Lower beta value is for iodine, so it has greater covalency. And the iodine will be softer ligand. And coming to metallite. So the beta value is always related to metal and ligand. Both metal and ligand. So nepholosophic effect is connected to metal and ligand also. So for now we have discussed about ligand, that is fluorine, water, urea, ammonia, oxo, Cn-, Br-, I-. So now coming to metal atom, M0, oxidation state is 0, M1, oxidation state plus 1, M2, M3. So increase in covalency means decrease in size. Decrease in size means what? Greater the oxidation state. So M3 plus M2 plus M plus means what? So here oxidation state plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. So which is greater in size? M plus 1 is greater in size. So M plus 1 or M0. M0 is greater in size. So that means decrease in size, increase in covalency. So lower in size is M3 plus. So greater in size is M. So this is the size, greater order of decreasing order of size. That means greater the size means lower the covalency. So metal M plus M, M plus 2, M plus 3. So first you understand which have the larger size. Which have the larger size? Metal atom will be larger in size. And plus means what? One electron is eliminated. So when one electron is eliminated, the shell will be decreased, the size will be smaller. So the cation will be always smaller. Anion is larger in size. So cation is smaller. So this is the order of decrease in size. So which is the smaller in size? M3 plus will be smaller in size. So M3 plus is smaller in size means what? Increase in covalency. So covalent character is greater for smaller size metal atom. So M3 plus M having plus 3 oxidation state will have greater covalency because it is smaller in size. And coming to ligand, which have the high covalency? Iodine. Iodine have low beta value, so it will have greater covalent character. So size and beta value are interrelated with covalent character and softness or hardness. Softer the ligand, decrease the beta value. So I will summarize today's section. First we discussed about delta O and V calculation. So for finding delta O, we have to find the configuration. D1, D6, D4, D9 have only one electron transition. So the delta O will be energy of that transition. And D3 and D8 have three electron transition. So the delta will be the lowest energy transition. And for D2 and D7, we need Tanabe-Sugano diagram, or we will take the difference in energy of second, first and third transition, or A2G, T2G terms. So that's not important. Next, coming to B value. So B is the Rakka parameter. For finding B value, 15B is equal to nu 3 plus nu 2 minus 3 nu 1. So from this formula, we can find the B value if nu is given. Next, we discussed about nepholosotic effect. So, N effect is what? Delocalization of electrons. Delocalization is interlinked to covalent character. So, greater the delocalization, greater the covalency, lower the beta value. Beta is the ratio of B complex by B metal ion, free ion. So, complex have less B value than metal ion, free ion. So, greater the beta value, decrease in covalency, or covalent character will be increased only if the beta value is low. And we discussed the ligand and metal value, beta value of ligand and metal. So, for metal, decrease in size, increase in covalent. And for ligands, beta value low, then increase in covalency. For just remember that iodine have lower beta value and iodine have greater covalency. Either you remember covalency or beta value. So iodine will have low beta value. And for metal ion, M3+, oxidation state is high. Higher oxidation state, lower in size, so greater the covalency. So M3+ will have covalency character more compared to M1 and M+2.